See, we are trying to see a couple of things. So this will be the structure of our presentation. First one we are trying to see is, one, what is the problem that we are trying to address? What is the problem? Then from the problem, we will go to, what are the available solutions that we can think of? Okay? Then third, we will see what are the problem, what is the solution, how are you going to implement that solution? And fourth, what are the factors we need to consider and be very careful in implementing the solution? Fifth, we are going to see what are the available ready-made solutions in the market. Do we have to start from the scratch, or can we use some ready-made solutions to have? So that will be the structure: problem, solution, how do you implement them, what are the things that you have to be careful about, and what are the ready-made solutions in the market. Let's go to the problem. The problem in the current one we are trying to address is, if I have an MCU and there is a pin, if I measure the value of this pin, what will the value be? Okay, that is the test setup. I'm explaining what is the testing setup. The testing setup is, take a microcontroller, take any one pin, for example GPIO pin, take your voltmeter and measure it. What will be its value? Okay. Now, this is your MCU. You have your particular, what did we say? Let's take a particular input pin and measure it. Ideally, what should happen if nothing is connected? For example, it can either be in the off state, or the value of the pin, if I say, can either be low or high. It has to be one of these. Right, the value of the pin has to be either low or it has to be high. Right, when nothing is connected. Low means what? Close to zero. It depends on how you define it. High means it can be either 5, 3 volts or whatever. But what we observe, this is the ideal case. This is what it should be. Right, when nothing is connected. But in the ideal case, in the real world, what happens? In the real world, what we observe is, the value of this input pin is something, some random value. So it can be 0, it can be 2 volt, 2.5, or it will be some random value, generally you observe. To address, this is the problem, to address this problem, we have something called address this problem. We address this problem by a pull up resistor. Pull up or pull down, but pull up is more famous. Let us see why this occurs. Now the question is, we say it is very random, but why? Why is it very random? Right? If you see that, what really happens is, see, in the environment you have lot of noise. In the environment, you have a lot of noise. There's a lot of EMFs, your telephone signals, your... there's a lot of noise. So, there is a lot of EMF, there's a lot of voltage. So, if you take a voltmeter and measure between what is the voltage between your hand and the ground, you'll find close to 0.7 volt. Okay, so there is some voltage. So this particular pin, it will not read zero because of all this noise and leakage that you find. You can call it noise or you can call it leakage. What really happens is, this is not zero. This will be some value. Okay, so here what you are just trying to put, your program here, let us say if it is off, it has to read. It's a switch. Okay, it's an LED switch. Let's say it's an LED switch. So this particular setup, let us just say that when I don't press, okay, when the switch is off, And when I press this, it is on, right? So ideally what should happen when it is off? Your LED should happen, what should happen? When it is off, it should not glow. When it is on, it should glow. That is what is your this one of LED, right? That's the purpose of your LED. So when it is off, sometimes what we find is when it is off, not connected, this LED sometimes blinks. It's on, off, when it is on it glows, but when it is off, it behaves in a very random way. To address that problem, why does that happen? Because there is some noise. Because of the noise, even if it when it is off, you will pick up some particular voltage. So voltage, ideally what should happen is this LED should be off. Okay, this is your LED. But then what we end up doing, this particular LED, it is random. To address this problem, we have pull-up resistor. So this is the description, okay, of why it happens. Because of the noise and leakage voltage that we have. When it is off, because of the leakage EMF, etc., this pin is, this particular one is called floating. We call this, hey, the pin is floating. It is not anchored. Okay, this is the concept to remember, that to address the problem of floating, we have the pull-up resistor for. Okay, main problem is address the problem of floating. But how do you address that problem of floating? Now let us take this condition. So this is your MCU. So instead of directly just connecting a button, what I do is I use some resistor, and I use the resistance, and I connect that resistance to either VCC. This is called pull up resistor. You also pull down, not very famous. Let's stick to pull up. You have a resistor, it's connected to VCC. Why do you do that? Why do you connect it? Because what happens is, see, your MCU also has some resistance, internal resistance, which is technically called impedance, right? This particular resistance that you call of the MCU, if you view it as a black box, this also has some resistance. This is called some impedance. Okay, so let us say when it is off, then what happens? This is some potential difference. There is some potential difference between this and the ground. The current cannot flow in this direction because it is off. So then what happens? Current will flow like this. It will flow through your to the ground. When it flows, what happens? Now let us say I select a resistance that is high. When the resistance is high, means what? Current will be low. When the current will be low, what will happen? What will be the potential difference here? There will be potential difference here minus the potential. There will be small potential difference that is against this, right? If I minus that VCC, minus some current will flow because of the resistance into the resistance that I have connected here, R1, will be my potential difference that I see here. If I use a very large resistance, very low current will fall. Then what will happen? This value will be close to VCC. So if this is 5 volt, the value here will be 4.98, 4.0, depending on what resistance that you choose. So higher resistance you choose, lower current means this value will be almost close to your VCC. So it is on. Okay. So when I have my button off, it is not connected. What is the value I am going to read here? It is going to be high, close to high. Now when I have it on, what is going to happen? When I just switch on the button, when you switch on the button, let us choose a different color. Let us choose green. When I switch this on, now these two are connected. Now the current that flows from here, what will happen? It can go either this way or this way, right? Since there is some resistance, there is no resistance here, right? It's just a wire. So current would say, hey, this is the path of my least resistance. I had better go this way. So what will be the current that flows through this side? It will almost be zero. Right? All the current will flow from here. All the current flows from here. What will be the potential here that you see when it is on? When it is on, you see almost the ground. Right? So it will be low. Right? So when it is on, since most of the current flows here, the value that you are going to see is going to be close to your ground. So when it is on, it will be close, it will be very, very low value. So then what happens? The problem that we have discussed, that it is floating, is addressed by this pull-up resistors. Okay? So that's the main idea. Now the question happens, what is the value that I'm going to choose, this R1? Normally what happens is, if you put it too high, there is a problem. If you put it too low, there is a problem. So normally what they do is, they take this value of R1 will be approximately equivalent to 10 times the value of your internal impedance of your MC, normally. So generally you use a resistor of 10 kilo ohm. Okay, why? Because that's a ballpark figure. We have to see what the value is. So there are some ballpark figure of how much resistance to be chosen. Don't use too high, don't use too low. Use a resistance that is 10 times the resistance here. Generally the resistance is some order. Okay, then that is the value that you are going to use there. Now, to make it more precise, this is the conditions. We said high means what? All when you have it off is what we had explained earlier. To say when it is off, what happens is current cannot flow this side, it is going to flow this side. Then when it is high, you will have almost close to 5 volt. When it is low, what will happen? All the current will flow here. Then the value that you get here will almost be the potential, since it is almost going here. The voltage would be close to zero. It will be close to zero. And why this occurs? We have already discussed, because of the EMF, to solve this problem. Okay, of floating voltage, we have this pull-up resistors. That's the main consideration. So low means pressed, high means not pressed. This we have to remember. When I say low, it means pressed. When I have pressed, it will be low. When I don't press it, it will be high. So to practice it a couple of times, you will get the value. Now what is the value of this resistance? We have already discussed what is that we have to use, right? Now take Arduino. So people, Arduino, when they manufacture, they have already, see, normally if you say, if you have input pull-up, if you put, there is a input 5, input pull-up, they already have a resistance that is already enabled. If you use this to value, read your value of your input, okay, if you use this input pull-up, that function you call the pin mode by passing a value input pull-up, it will already enable an internal pull-up resistor. Okay, that's all you have to do. So for example, you have your button, you just do input pull-up. Some of the microcontrollers have this already implemented. That's all. They know, since it is high, low, off, right? So that's that is how it is implemented. So that's all. That's all is the summary of what we have discussed today. Thank you.